So what happens when we regularly eat prasadam? There are other things that happen. We are eradicated of our sins. Then, this is from the Chandogya Upanishad, quoted in the purport of Bhagavad Gita chapter 3, text 11. Ahara shuddhau sattva shuddhi, sattva shuddhau dhruva smritihi, smriti lambhe sarvagranthinam vipramokshaha. By performance of yajna, one's eatables become sanctified. We are sanctifying our eatables. And by eating sanctified foodstuffs, prasadam, one's very existence becomes purified. Sattva shuddhi. Sattva means existence. Shuddhi means it will become purified. Our existence becomes purified. That means, in other words, as long as we are eating meat, we cannot. If we are not eating purified foodstuff, if we are not eating prasadam, we are contaminated. By the purification of existence, finer tissues in the memory become sanctified. See how it is working. It's very subtle, you know. And when memory is sanctified, one can think of the path of liberation, and all these combined together lead to Krishna consciousness, the great necessity of present day society. We want to remember shlokas, we want to remember the philosophy, we want to, how? We just eat rubbish, how we can understand and remember? No, we cannot. We have to eat purified foodstuffs, we have to do all these things, and then we can understand Krishna consciousness. So this is why also a spiritual master is very satisfied when his devotees are taking prasadam, because that will give them the intelligence to understand Krishna. Same thing in the second chapter, 65th verse. Prasade sarvadukhanam hani rasyopajayate prasanna chetaso hi ashu buddhi paryavatishthate. Prasade sarvadukhanam hanir asya upajayate. So by prasadam, of course here it is mentioned as when you achieve the mercy of the Lord, then all your, you know, read the translation. For one thus satisfied in Krishna consciousness, by the mercy of the Lord, when one is satisfied, the threefold miseries of material existence exist no longer. In such satisfied consciousness, one's intelligence is soon well established. This is spoken in a general way, Krishna's mercy, but the same applies to prasadam. In fact, Prabhupada used this quote in reference to prasadam in one place. Prasade sarva dukhanam hani rasopajate. We have two dukkhas, the dukkha of the body, the dukkha of the soul. The primary dukkha of the body is hunger. So that is satisfied, and the hunger of the soul is also satisfied by prasadam simultaneously. Sarva dukhanam. Hanir means mitigates. Prasade sarva dukhanam hanir asyopajayate prasanna chetasa. He becomes very happy. You give prasadam to anybody, they'll become very happy. Anybody, they'll become very happy when you give prasadam. When you talk philosophy, they sometimes become angry at you. But if you want to make them happy, give them prasadam. Even in the material way, it is said that the best way to a man's heart is through his stomach. You know, if you want to satisfy someone, if you want to win over his heart, first cook for him nicely and offer nice foodstuff. You know, when he likes the foodstuff, then slowly, that's how Priti Lakshanam, no? That is Priti Lakshanam. Dadati Pratigrahanati Guhyamakhyati Prichyati Bhungte Bhojayate Chaiva. Offering prasadam and accepting prasadam. In this way, devotees build a rapport among themselves, and then they will develop the strong friendship, bonds of friendship. Prasanna Chetasa. He ashu, very quickly, he becomes very happy. And buddhihi paryavatishthate, one's intelligence, here you see, is soon well established. Our intelligence becomes well established. What is well established? That means, in instructions of Krishna, following the instructions, you know, this is well established intelligence. When we are whimsically acting, then that is not a well established intelligence. That is a misdirected intelligence. So, prasadam will lead to all these things. Therefore, spiritual master is very happy.